Hello students, this is the second lecture from the unit 1 OEC 552 Soft Computing. This lecture helps us to learn the biological neural structure, comparison over your artificial neural network and basic models available for artificial neural network, what are the parameters involved in the artificial neural networks and its functionality. So neural network generally is a highly interconnected networks of large number of processing elements called neurons that are inspired by the human brain. Neural network characteristics are mapping capability, it can associate the pattern, generalize anything it sees, robustness, fault tolerant and parallel and high speed information processing. This is a biological neural structure. Here we have a soma, otherwise it is called as a cell body. The synapses are the connection point where it carries the output, the electrical output. Dendrites is a signal which connects the nervous system to the cell body. Axon which carries the information, after that it carries the information to the synapses. Same thing we want to try to the artificial neural network. Instead of this synapses, now we have the link. Each link is having weight. Here we have the electrical pulses. Each pulses having its own weightage. To indicate the pulses weight here, we assign the W1, W2, W3 and so on, WN weights for all the input. All the inputs are gathered here. Only activation happens because of this axon. To simulate that one, we have an activation factor called a threshold. Based on that one, the output will be generated here. So multiplying each input with the weight X1, W1 plus X2, W2 plus and so on, xn wn is the summation, and you are going to add that with the bias. This is a biological neural. Get the electrical pulses between the dendrites and the synapses. It comes to the soma. After that, output carries to the axon. Output of axon will be sent to the bulb-like structure called the synapses. So there are three mains for the biological neural structure. One is soma, another one is dendrites. Another one is axon. Soma is otherwise called as a cell body where the nucleus is located. Dendrites where the nervous system is connected to the cell body. Axon which carries the impulses of the neuron. And after that axon, it passes through the synapses. So electric impulse always passes between the synapses and dendrites here. And synapses, that is a small bulb-like structure present in the end of the axon here. It is a chemical process which results in increasing or decreasing electrical potential depending upon the weightage of the signal produced, is it, inside the body of the receiving cell. If the electric potential reaches its own threshold value, when the that time the neuron will be fired, then action will be taken place that they send to the axon, and axon carry the information to the synaptic junction. After that, cell has to wait for the refractory period to get the another signal. Same thing we want to try in the artificial neural network. You can see here, instead of the interconnection between that soma to through the synapses, we develop the links. Each link is interconnected with all the other neurons. Now we are having 5 plus 4, 9 neurons, 3 for input, 4 in the hidden layer and 2 for the output. Now we take the image and recognize whether the image is talking about the dog or cat, carries the information from the input layer to the hidden layer. Hidden layer will process the information, sends its own output to the output layer with its weight. Based on the assigned weight and the input signal from the hidden layer, output will decide whether the given image is dog or not. How the artificial neural networks are designed, it try to resemble the characteristics of the biological neuron. So instead of we have the soma, now we call that as the nodes. Nodes are interconnected processing element. It is a unit of a program or process or a system. Neuron is connected to other neuron by a connection link instead of synapses or dendrites. Each connection link is associated with the weight value that carries the information about the input signal. ANN processing elements are called as neuron or artificial neuron since they have the capability to model the networks of original neuron as found in the brain. So, internal state of the neuron is called as activation or activation level, activity level. When the input signals is carried, they'll multiply with the weight. If the summation of the input and multiplied with the weight greater than the threshold value, that output neuron will be triggered. The neuron can send only one signal at a time. This is a sample neural network which carries only the two input and one output node. Input is x1, x2. Input neurons are x1 and x2. Why talking about the output neuron? W1 and W2 are weight assigned to the first link and weight assigned to the second link. How to calculate the net input that passes through the Y? Net input is Y in multiplying the x1 with the W1 plus x2 with the W2. Here we use a minus sign. Assume that I pass the minus 1 here. Then the signal will be minus x1 w1 plus x2 w2. How to calculate the output? We have to apply the output function for this y in. After applying this activation function, it will generate the output either 0 or the 1. So, suppose there are so many input nodes connected to the y node, then I have to summate all the input x1 w1 plus x2 w2 and so on. Xn Wn, that entire input I called as the Yn. So I can shortly write I is equal to 1 to n Xi into Wi. How to compare this biological neural system with the artificial neural network? Here we call that as the cell, now it is neuron. The entities are nothing but the weights or interconnection. Soma is the net input, axon is the layer where we are passing the output. The speed in the brain execution time is few milliseconds. But the computer, it is few nanoseconds. It can carry the parallel processing, but several parallel processing simultaneously we can done by using computer system. It is faster than biological neuron. Size and capabilities of the brain. Number of interconnection is 10 power 11 and 10 power 15. So complexity of the brain is higher than the computer. But it depends upon the application as well as network engineer who is designing the ANN, it will vary. Storage capacity of the brain, information is stored in interconnection or the synapse strength. New information can be stored without destroying the old one. Sometimes fails to recollect the information when we are getting older age. But for your computer stored in a continuous memory location, overloading may destroy the older location, can easily be retrieved. And tolerance level in your brain, that's fault tolerant. Store and retrieve information, even the internet connection is failed, accept the redundancy. Accepting the redundancy is not possible with your computer system. If at all we support the fault tolerance, it will support. Otherwise, no fault tolerance. Information corrupted if the network connections are disconnected. Control mechanism. Entire mechanism is supported by the neural connection. CPU only controls everything in the computer system. These are some basic structure of the ANN. So, only one set of input layer and output layer. The name of the structure is single layer. Feed forward. We are feeding in the forward direction. Suppose we have a multiple layer, input layer, hidden layer, output layer. Then it is called as a multi-layer and feeding in a one direction, feed forward network. Third variety, instead of feeding in only one side, you can get the feedback again to the input node. So that is called as a recurrent network. Input, number of hidden layers, output. So there are some basic models of the ANN. Instead of representing the complexity in the ANN, we simplify that models into 5 group. The models synaptic interconnection differentiate each and everything, and training or learning groups adapted for updating and adjusting the connection weight. The arrangements of neurons to form the layer and the interconnection patterns are formed within and between the layers. There are 5 types: single layer feed forward, multi-layer feed forward, single node with its own feedback, single layer recurrent and multi layer recurrent. This is a single layer feed forward, only input and output. Layers are combined with the other processing element. Input and output links are linked to each other. So each have its own weightage. We calculate the net input, apply the activation over the net input and calculate the output. This is multi layer. Instead of a single layer, we have a hidden layer. There are two hidden layers. input will be carried from this input layer to the hidden layer 1 with its own weightage. Output is processed. Then result will be carried to the second hidden layer with its own weight. Then the R1 will process that input, carry the output to the next layer. Y1 will decide what is the output. So Y1, Y2, Yn are output neuron. X1, X2, Xn are input neuron. Z1, Z2, Zk is the hidden layer 1 neuron. R1, R2 and so on RQ are hidden layer 2 neuron. This is a feedback network. Instead of feeding in a forward direction, you can get the feedback and feed it to the input again. That single node with its own feedback. Second one is a competitive node. All the nodes are assigned with the equal weights and also you are having the feedback loop. Suppose you want to feed the output back to the individual node. There are so many neurons, then it is called as a single layer recurrent network. Recurrent is reoccurring the same input, feeding the feedback back to the input node and process again, give the result. It will give the improved result. You go for a n iteration, you will get the n iterated output. This is the another structure which contains the multi-layer recurrent network. Instead of only one input layer and output layer, now we have the n number of hidden layer here. Output is feedback to the hidden layer. Hidden layer will process, assign its own weight v11, v12, v13 and so on v1m. Same way from the Z2 to the Y2 layer V22, V21, V2M, Zk, VZ1, Z2 and so on Zm. The neural network carries the machine learning. You know the meaning for a machine learning. Automatically it learns from the samples we are providing. There are two kinds of ANN. One, we can adjust our parameter. Through the parameter we can learn. One important parameter in the neural network is weight. Another one, we focus on the structure of the neural network. Based on the updation over the neural networks, updates from the single layer to the multi-layer, multi-layer to the multiple hidden layer, and apply the feedback and changes the recurrent layer and so on. Apart from this learning or parameter or structure, there are three famous type of learning. One is called a supervised, another one is unsupervised. Third one is reinforcement. Feeding the input as well as output training pair is called as a supervised learning. Only give the input, allow the algorithm for clustering or grouping the similarities between the input, generate the pattern is called unsupervised learning. Third one, similar to the supervised learning, you are advised with the teacher. That the teacher will give you the punishment or the reward based on your step. Taken. If the step is reward, then you carry the step for next time. If the step is punishment, you won't repeat the same step. Same way, you are going to learn something is called as reinforcement learning. So, there are three important machine learning. One is supervised. Another one is unsupervised. Third one is reinforcement learning. Remaining concept regarding this ANN, we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you, students.